So Gmail and Google Calendar are very tightly integrated. So when you send a meeting invite from Calendar to somebody through Gmail, the recipient can click on the invite and it will automatically be added to their calendar if they choose yes or maybe. If they say no, it will reject the calendar invite. Occasionally, somebody will send you a meeting invite from a different application. So for example, they'll send it from Outlook or from Lotus Notes, or from a program like Mac Mail, or occasionally those meeting invites might come from a web-based webinar application like WebEx. If you get a meeting invite like this is one that comes from WebEx directly, you can't have a link that says, yes, I'll go, or no, I won't, because it's coming from a third-party vendor. But it gives you this pencil it in feature. This is actually a nice little feature. By clicking on any date, so here it says Tuesday, January 14th, clicking on any date stamp, it gives you the ability to add a time. So in this case, the time would be, we'll say 2:30, and you can add it to the calendar. It'll automatically add that meeting to your calendar. If I come over here and I refresh the calendar, you see the meeting is right here. Now, occasionally, in the meeting invite, if it comes from Mac Mail, it will include a file extension of type ICS. Now, what is ICS? It's also popularly known as iCalendar, and a lot of applications will use it. For example, in WebEx, if you hit Add to My Calendar, it will download a file type, and it will save it, and it will allow you to name it. Here's one I saved ahead of time, but you notice here it's an iCalendar file, and it's a dot extension of ICS. Well, double clicking on this will actually try to open up Outlook or one of the others, because it isn't automatically set up to take the ICS file and bring it into Calendar. You have to take a couple of manual steps to import this invite into your calendar. Well, how do you do that? It's actually pretty simple. You go into your calendar, you go into your other calendars, and you look for the downward arrow. You click on the down arrow and you hit Import Calendar. Browse to the file. So in this case, I'm going to go into my downloads. I'm going to find this test ICS file. I'm going to hit Open. And then it asks you what calendar you would like to import it into. So the term Import Calendar here is actually a little bit misleading. It should be called Import Event. So you're not importing an entire calendar, you're just importing an event and adding it to one of your existing calendars. So in this case, I'm going to import it into this training mailbox calendar here. I'll hit import, and it'll say how many it processed. Sometimes you have more than one event, but you go ahead and hit close, and you can see it added that calendar event to my calendar.